In this video, we are going to take a look at data preparation to start with, followed by classification with the help of decision tree. And finally, we also see how is the performance of this classification. So let's get started with data preparation. I'm going to use the same data that we had for the previous video, but note that there we had taken a random sample. This time we'll use all 100 values. I will create a pattern to start with, and let's name this as 100 because it involves all 100. So first 100 values were normal. I'm specifying that normal repeats 100 times. And then we have cyclic, which also repeats 100 times, followed by increasing trend. And then we have decreasing trend, upward shift. And finally, the sixth one is downward shift. So we can run this. It will create like 600 values, 100 with each pattern. And our data set, which is data, has, remember, 60 columns. I'm going to create a data frame that has original data values. And also the last column is going to be pattern 100 that we just created. And let's store this in new data. If you want to look at structure of this, you can do str new data. So it lists all the variables. Now it says 61 variables and we have 600 observations, so that many rows. And 61st one is a factor with 6 levels. So these 6 levels are these 6 patterns like cyclic, normal, and so on. Now let's use this data for doing classification. And we'll use a library called party. This is for like partitioning. So we use this package. And since this is not installed, I'm going to go to install. So once the package is installed, we can run this library. And then we can make use of a function called ctree, which stands for classification tree. And we want to do the classification for patterns. So I'm going to use pattern 100 as a function of this tilde sign, and dot means all 60 variables. And our data is new data. And let's store this tree in tree. So it hardly takes any time. If you want to look at the tree, you can run this. And it shows you that there are 25 terminal nodes. And in fact, there are 49 branches. So we don't go into details of decision tree in this one. So we can create a table. We can use predict to do the prediction using tree model. And we want to do this prediction for new data that we have. We can also specify that actual data is new data $ pattern 100. So this will create a table here. So let me create some more room. In fact, I'm also going to say that this is predicted and this is actual. So this is the table we get. As you know, this is a confusion matrix. So we have 6 different patterns and we have predicted patterns here. So as you know, the values on the diagonal indicate how many correct predictions are there, and off diagonal items indicate how many misclassifications are there. But we can also calculate overall accuracy by adding all the diagonal items and dividing by the total number. So I'm going to store this table in TAB tab. And we want to calculate the accuracy of this classification. So what we can do is we can do sum of all the diagonal items in the tab and divide that by total in the tab. So once we run this, we get 95.1%. So that means this classification is about 95% accurate. If the pattern, actual pattern, is cyclic, this model also predicts that to be cyclic. If actual pattern is decreasing trend, then this classification model also predicts that to be decreasing trend, and so on. So out of the misclassifications, the biggest number that I see is 8. So there are 8 misclassifications. So actually there was downward shift. The model predicts downward trend. And there is one number which is like perfect, so 100. So all the normal patterns are predicted to be normal with 100% accuracy. And the lowest number I see is 89. So the maximum confusion is for downward shift. So in this section, we went over time series decomposition with R. We also looked at how to do time series forecasting. And that was followed up by doing time series clustering. We made use of hierarchical clustering to do that. And finally, in this video, we looked at time series classification with R.